Please join me in saying the Pledge of Allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hi, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Natalie Tebow, and thank you all for coming today. When people think of teenagers, they automatically think of the stereotypical kids who think that they're indestructible. And maybe we do think that. Maybe it's just a part of being human. We are wild and reckless, believing the power of our own gods will keep us safe. But we learn from our mistakes. We may be ignorant and entitled at times, but we are kind and compassionate, intelligent, and fiercely protective of all that we love. We were raised in a generation of hope, and that hope has kept us moving forward when we thought we couldn't take another step. We have been brilliant and we have been broken, but our dreams will take us far. The best years of our lives are not our high school years, but the years that have yet to come. We have the ability to change the world in a million different ways. Every single one of us has worked so hard to reach this rite of passage to be able to graduate high school with our peers. And while this diploma will open many doors for our futures, I want you to keep this in mind. You are so much more than a piece of paper.
Hello, everyone. There's nothing I'm about to tell you which you don't already know. You've heard this all before, whether by the words of others or our own inner voice. But I know for myself, at least, that reminders can help make us through our choices. There's something called the hedonic treadmill, the principle that no matter what we gain or lose, we tend to stabilize at the same level of happiness. This is why billionaires are not paragons of joy. They are fortunate not to have the same problems we do, but as far as happiness goes, it doesn't matter. In the absence of problems, the brain creates its own. That is why, although improving quality of life is important, it's not a guarantor of happiness. Instead, we can find our peace by changing our measures of success. In careers, instead of simply desiring the results of our work, like money, fame, or prestige, we should primarily value the merit of the work itself. Or maybe placing value in your job isn't for you. Working is part of life, but it doesn't have to define living, despite what society often tells us. While some find value in their work, others do in their families, friends, or service. There's a simple test we can do to see whether we're doing things for the right reasons. Ask, if I couldn't tell anyone about doing it, and it wouldn't bring me prestige or wealth, would I still do it? That question guides us to understanding how and why we value the things we do. I ask that when you make decisions going into the future, think not only of their end result, but how they will affect you every day. Happiness is not met with reaching goals, but the struggle of reaching them. Don't forget that, like many things, life is more about the journey than the destination.
Thank you.
You know, I'm kind of obsessed with space. I love the stars. There are many reasons why. They're incredible and complex feats of physics. They are the creators of all the atoms in our universe. And when I look at them, it takes my breath away. There are more stars in the universe than there are grains of sand on our whole Earth. My mom says that freaks her out, but I think it's crazy cool. Another fascinating thing about stars is their gravity. Stars have such powerful gravity that they have the ability to create planets and later rip them apart. We have gravity too. We obviously can't make any planets, but we do have a huge effect on each other, especially in a small town like this. Maybe we didn't all have a direct influence on each other, but most of us shared a class, or had lockers close together, or maybe just passed by in the hallway every day. We're connected, whether we like it or not. And let's be real, we did not always like it. We didn't always get along. We hurt and got hurt. But in the end, we usually got over it, because you kind of have to when you're stuck with the same people every day. We've been through a lot together. Our class was the first to have all-day kindergarten, the first to have fifth grade in middle school, and the first to have to suffer through the SAT instead of the ACT. Just while we've been in high school, a deer broke through a window, the power went out and we hung out in the dark for a bit, and someone drove into the gas main. That's crazy. But we went through all this and more together, and we'll always have a kind of connection because of that. We have no idea what the future holds. I mean, we kind of think we do, but we honestly have minimal control over what happens to us. Life throws a lot of curveballs. Even stars are disrupted by outside forces like black holes, far out of their reach. We don't know what we'll have tomorrow, but we do have this. We have our past together. We have these memories. We are who we are today because of each other. Little bits of ourselves came from those around us, from teachers, parents, friends, coaches, acquaintances, even strangers. And we will take that with us wherever we go. We have this moment. We have each other. And that's something we're holding on to.
I would like to take a minute to congratulate the class of 2017. It has been my pleasure to get to know you this year. I'm excited for the journey that you're about to take, whether it be college, a career, the armed forces. Remember, you're always a student. The staff here at Cheboygan High School not only work with your parents to prepare you educationally, but also help form you as the young adults you are today to go out and conquer your dreams. Remember, you can't change the direction of the wind, but you can adjust your sails to always reach your destination. Congratulations and good luck on your journey. At this time, I'd like to introduce the Cheboygan Area School's Board of Education. Frank Snyder, Lazarus Brown, Marianne Riding, and Jenny Hayden.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Cheboygan Area High School as we celebrate our 130th high school commencement ceremony. Along with the administrative team, Mr. Janat, Mrs. Sandy Janat, and myself, I would like to thank the Board of Ed, the community, and especially the parents for entrusting to us the most important task of educating these young men and women. On this Memorial Day weekend, I would also like to thank those veterans and current military personnel. Would you please stand if you're in the audience today? You have represented our country and are role models to our graduates, teaching by example the importance of service, commitment, and sacrifice. Thank you. To the class of 2017, I'm glad to be among the first to congratulate you. You've demonstrated much growth over the last 4 years and have demonstrated skills and strengths in impressive ways. In fact, you can say you've left a calling card in and around Cheboygan Area High School. On those calling cards, it says that you are musicians, you are actors, athletes, technicians, welders, bakers, scholars. Together, you have earned over $775,000 in scholarships. Over $100,000 of this was from the generosity of businesses and families in our community. Thank you all. Visits to CHS and hearing about all your successes and accomplishments and seeing what your new calling cards have to say. So without further delay, class of 2017, please come forward to receive your diplomas. Aaron Robert Nelson, top 10.
A $1,000 award in honor of my father-in-law, Arthur Henry Leader, who was a mathematician.
Heather Elaine Schultz, top 10, Central Michigan University Academic Prestige Award, Central Michigan University Maroon and Gold Scholarship.
$1,000 award in honor of my mother, Ethel Jewel Felt, class of 1928.
Or, oh, wow. Again, I'm very honored to present a $450 scholarship from Cheboygan High School.
Receiving a McAfee scholarship. Mr. and Mrs. McAfee reside on Babel Island and very much support our Cheboygan area schools. $3,000 scholarships are reserved for seniors attending a Northern Michigan college, and two $3,000 scholarships are reserved for students attending any Michigan public college. Students must have a 2.5 GPA.
We're so honored to join you from Albuquerque, New Mexico. We're here today to dedicate a scholarship in honor of Pamela M. Galbraith. She was born and raised here, graduating with the Cheboygan High class of 1966. She attended North Central, earning her nursing degree, and then worked at Community Memorial Hospital here in Cheboygan. In 1972, she moved to New Mexico and began a 33-year career at the University of New Mexico Medical Center. First as a nurse, and later she held 17 professional positions, including administrator for the entire mental health program at the University of New Mexico. Having earned a master's degree in business administration and becoming an advocate for the people of the state of New Mexico, she saved many rural hospitals in New Mexico because she felt so strongly that communities should determine their own health care. After retiring from UNM, she became the CEO of Value Options, managing a billion-dollar budget for all the mental health services for our state, New Mexico. She was a tireless worker, extremely focused, dedicated, expecting total commitment of herself and others to achieve success. Though she served on presidential appointed commissions, she never lost her small-town roots. She was humble. It's important to know that Cheboygan was home. I'm speaking on behalf of my father. We were married here and visited every year for 40 years. We've maintained lifelong friendships with the finest people I've ever known. I was married to one. This scholarship is a means of assisting you in your pursuit of excellence. We wish you all the best in this next chapter.
Top 10. Emily also is receiving a $1,000 scholarship from the Gilner Family Female Athlete Scholarship. Congratulations.
Abigail Rose Mill, top 10, Michigan Technological University Presidential Scholarship of Excellence. Abby has also been awarded the McAfee Scholarship. As we know, McAfee's arrived on Babalo Island, and they are much supporters of Cheboygan Area Schools. She is receiving one of the $3,000 scholarships for seniors attending a Northern Michigan college. Addison Grace Fletcher, top 10, Student Council Representative.
Good afternoon, I'm presenting the Zach Barber Memorial Scholarship. Zach loved to say, it's not what the world can do for me, but what I can do for the world. This scholarship recognizes the student that tries to include everyone in the community. Addison, you are recognized as being that student for this class. Hopefully you can continue doing that and use this money to aid in your future. Good luck.
Addie is also receiving the Jackson Family Scholarship for her outstanding performance in soccer. Anthony William Pizzo Paquette, Class President. Derek Anthony View, Class Vice President, University of Michigan Alumni Scholarship. Cooper Scott Kelly, MASC, MAHS, Center 2 Representative, Central Michigan University Leader Advancement Scholarship, Central Michigan University Academic Success Award. Cooper is also receiving the Cantile Family Scholarship. One $500 scholarship is reserved for a graduating senior with at least a 3-point GPA who has rostered in the same sport for a minimum of 3 seasons. The student must be accepted as a full-time student at any 2- or 4-year accredited college. Cooper is also receiving the Cheboygan Little League and Jim Ellenbaugh scholarships. This is two $500 scholarships for one female and one male athlete. They're reserved for students who have participated in Little League for at least 3 years, and the students must have at least a 2.5 GPA.
Congratulations, graduates. The Terry Elliott Scholarship was developed when my aunt passed away after an amazingly great battle with inflammatory pneumonia. She was 54. She had many passions, especially for the written word. It's an honor to present this one-time $2,000 scholarship for writing and communication.
Jeffrey Lee Ostman, MASC, MAHS, Center 2 Representative, Grand Valley State University Award for Excellence Scholarship, Grand Valley State University Early Awareness Scholarship, Presqu'île Electric and Gas Communities First Fund Scholarship.
Michigan University, which applies.
wisely granted him acceptance. We know that Jeffrey's work in college will reflect his defining key components of good character, which are persistence and individuality in overcoming adversity. Congratulations, Jeffrey.
As the board president for Straight Sierra Community Foundation, I'm very honored to present Jeffrey with a $450 Cheboygan High School scholarship.
First of all, I'd like to thank all the faculty, the students, janitorial staff, and all the community for allowing the Rotary Club of Cheboygan to present quite a few scholarships today. Please give the staff a great hand. Jeffrey, the Rotary Club is proud to present to you a $1,000 scholarship going to Western Michigan University. Hopefully, you're going to continue in business administration. Get a stand on these sides.
No one but that.
Scholarship.
I am here to present Jeffrey with the community's first fund $1,000 scholarship.
Jeffrey is also going to receive a $500 scholarship for vocational arts for participating in our vocational trades here at Cheboygan. Black Lake Chapter of Sturgeon for tomorrow, we'd like to present Jeffrey with a $500 scholarship.
Emma Lynn Cabot, Student Council Representative.
Biology. Very good luck. Thank you very much.
Mitchell Birdsall. Kaylee Ray Bishop. Seth Nathaniel Marcus Bitterman. Thank you. Hayes Chamberlain.
Sierra is receiving a McAfee scholarship. The McAfees reside on Pablo Island and are very much supportive of Cheboygan High Schools. There are three $3,000 scholarships awarded to seniors attending a Northern Michigan college and two $3,000 scholarships reserved for students attending any public Michigan college. Courtney Sue Christopher. Courtney is receiving the Cheboygan Little League and Jim Ellenboss scholarships. She's receiving a $500 scholarship for a female reserved for CAHS students who have participated in Little League for at least 3 years. Students must have at least a 2.5 GPA.
Douglas Daly.
On behalf of the Cheboygan County Firefighters Association, it is my honor to give Jordan a $500 scholarship. Congratulations.
Trent John Richard Demuse, Fair State University Crimson Scholarship. Brenton Joseph Dixon.
Thank you.
Gunther, Olivet College B. Moore Scholarship, Olivet College Shipburn Scholarship. Angel Albert Guerrero.
$500 scholarship reserved for a student attending a public college or university. receiving the Noreen McCabe Memorial Scholarship. It's two $1,000 scholarships reserved for students having at least a 2.5 GPA. Lauren is also receiving the Straits Area Federal Credit Union Scholarship. Congratulations.
Elizabeth Uriah Justice. Isaiah John Kennedy. Student from Austria. Kyle John Kilpatrick. Madison Baden Ott Community College Leadership Scholarship.
We know that Stephen's work in college will reflect his three defined key components of good character, which are selflessness, supporting others, and hard work.
On behalf of the Black Lake Chapter of Sturgeon for Tomorrow, we'd like to offer Stephen a $500 scholarship.
Stephen is also receiving the Cheboygan County Farm Bureau Scholarship. It's a $500 scholarship that is available to any Cheboygan County student. Stephen is also receiving the McAfee Scholarship. As we know, the McAfees are from Bago Island, and he will be receiving one of the $3,000 scholarships.
Samantha Ann Manning. Emily Elaine Maynard.
$500 scholarship reserved for a student attending a public college or university.
Brayley Ann McCombie. Jeremy Tyler McGrath. Cole William May. Cooper Jean Moore, United States Navy. Daniel Robert Nash.
Dan's also going to receive a $1,000 scholarship from the Junction 33 Collision and a $600 scholarship from the Northern Michigan Welding Educators Scholarship. Congratulations.
$1,000 from the Rotary Scholarship, and he is going to CDA Technical Institute in Jacksonville, Florida. And he's going swimming because he's taking up underwater welding. I've never heard of it, but good luck to him on his endeavor.
Siena Heights University Presidential Academic Scholarship, Siena Heights University Art Scholarship, Siena Heights University Music Scholarship.
Daniel is also receiving one of the Gilder Family Visual Performing Arts Scholarship. It's a $1,000 scholarship reserved for a senior with at least a 3.0 GPA who's pursuing a degree related to visual performing arts. Daniel is also receiving the Wendy Cockins Fine Arts Scholarship. It is a $500 scholarship reserved for a senior pursuing higher education in an arts-related accredited field.
Holly Elizabeth Nysted. Jordan Olivia Neeson, Edward Adams Memorial Scholarship. Zoya Andreeva Northrup.
Towards North Central Michigan College, and I'm here today to present our presidential scholarship, which is selected, one student is selected from Cheboygan each year, and that student must have maintained a 3.5 grade point average or higher, and shows good leadership abilities. This scholarship is our most prestigious scholarship because it is good for 2 years of fully paid tuition and fees.
Jackson Douglas Ormsby. Joseph Radel, Central Michigan University Academic Excellence Award.
On behalf of the Cheboygan Junior Chiefs, this is a $500 scholarship.
Mike is also receiving the R.J. Galter Scholar Athlete Award. Again, it's an award that receives plaques, and it's for one male and one female CHS student athlete. The selections are chosen by the head coaches. Students have to have a 3.0 and above and have lettered in a sport. Mike is also receiving the Leo Yek Scholarship. It is a $500 scholarship reserved for a student who has participated in sports for at least 2 years in high school. Mike is also receiving the Maureen McCabe Memorial Scholarship. It is $1,000 scholarship reserved for a student to have at least a 2.5 GPA. Congratulations.
Chase William Ramsby, United States Marine Corps. Thank you.
Gabrielle is also receiving the Lloyd B. Gua Memorial Scholarship. This is a $1,000 scholarship reserved for a student who is interested in becoming a teacher. Reference is given to those who plan to teach industrial arts, but I'm not sure that's what she's doing.
Zachary James Stemke. Ethan Riley Steed. Brandon Lee Strait. Cassandra Grace Thornton, Eastern Michigan University Emerald Award. Norma Ugas Reno, exchange student from Spain. Ethan Joseph Walt. Michaela Marie Watson. Nicholas Charles Francis Weiss. Macy Lynn White, Central Michigan University Academic Success Award.
I'm pleased to present on behalf of the Straits Area Community Foundation a scholarship of $450 for Macy from Cheboygan High School Scholarship Fund.
We are proud to award Macy with the second of two Pamela M. Gilbert Beaumont Scholarship Awards. The first two of these have been granted. This scholarship is the amount of $500 and is renewable up to 3 more years. It is granted to students pursuing a degree in the medical field. Congratulations, Macy.
Macy's also receiving the Cheboygan Memorial Hospital Medical Staff Scholarship. This is a scholarship available to Straits Area seniors who will be attending an accredited institution to study human health care. She is also receiving the CalSite Credit Union Scholarship. This is a $1,000 scholarship available to graduating seniors from Roger City, Posen, Onaway, Alpena, or Cheboygan, and they have to be members of the credit union.
Tyler Philip Wilkinson.
Way to go, Tyler!
Brady Lee Williams. Thank you. Caitlin Marie Williams, Cheboygan County 4-H Senior Scholarship. Receiving the Kiwanis Scholarship, which is also a $500 scholarship reserved for students attending a public college or university. Caitlin is also going to receive one of the McAfee Scholarships. Mr. and Mrs. McAfee are very much supporters of Cheboygan Area Schools. This is there are three $3,000 scholarships awarded to seniors attending Northern Michigan colleges. Caitlin is also receiving the Mike Drake Memorial Scholarship. This is one $1,000 scholarship. Preference is given to a student who has completed at least one season on the Cheboygan golf team. Congratulations, Caitlin.
Thank you. Thank you.